5 reasons why Washington's offense will be much improved in 2021. Hi everybody, I'm Greg and welcome to the Washington Football Maniacs channel. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and hit that notification bell so you will never miss another video release. So number one, Ryan Fitzpatrick. Ryan Fitzpatrick arguably had one of his best seasons in 2020. Of course, until he got pulled in favor of the Dolphins' first-round draft pick in Tua out of Alabama. However, in the past couple of seasons, Ryan Fitzpatrick has actually had better stats than some of the biggest names and some of the best quarterbacks in the NFL, including Tom Brady. Ryan Fitzpatrick's all guts and hopefully some sort of glory type of play, I think, will be something that fits right on in with the style of how we want to have the Washington football team playing on offense in 2021. And most certainly, he's going to have some outstanding wide receivers and tight ends to throw to. Which brings me to point number two, the wide receivers. In 2021, we are going to have not only Terry McLaurin and then whoever else decides to step up and make a play here and there, we're actually going to have a pretty stacked wide receiving corps. In fact, we are so loaded at wide receiver right now that we're probably going to wind up having to cut some wide receivers that we would hate to see go, but certainly also wide receivers that could start for any other team. But with the likes of guys like Curtis Samuel, for instance, who has already established himself as a big threat wide receiver, and then drafting UNC's Diami Brown. Yep, you're not going to give me any more crap about mispronouncing his first name. Who has the potential of being a deep threat burner type of wide receiver. It's going to be really fun, folks, to see how this wide receiving group is going to be able to make some big plays, but it's going to take a lot of pressure off of Terry McLaurin, who has already established himself as Washington's number one wide receiver. My third point is Antonio Gibson. Antonio Gibson made some big plays for us last year. I mean, he was one of the big standouts of the Washington football team in 2020. He firmly established himself as the number one running back out of the backfield. And this year, so far in OTAs, he looks bigger, he looks stronger, he looks faster, much more improved, and he even talked about playing injured a lot. And so being able to have a healthy Antonio Gibson coming out of the backfield and then possibly lining him up with the likes of Curtis Samuel, who can make some of those really nice plays out of the backfield as well. I think we're going to see a big, big year for Antonio Gibson. In fact, I think he's going to be considered one of the stars in this league. No, no, no. I'm not wearing my burgundy and gold glasses, am I? And more about the wide receivers and the running backs and all of this and tight ends. We're also talking about depth. And depth is something that is huge for this team. I believe in recent years we had high quality starters on this team, but the problem is that then our starters would get injured and then suddenly our offense would be thin, would have to go and sign players off of other teams, like on waivers and things like that, and would have to promote people from the practice squad just to have a body in there to actually play some games. And so I think with Ron Rivera, one thing that he wanted to make sure was competition in every single position on this team. Competition also breeds depth. And good quality depth, meaning the fact that if you have good quality depth, then your starters can take a break, have someone else rotating in. You're not going to have a big drop-off of talent and skill. And I think that is extremely important if you're going to be a championship football team. You need to have quality depth, especially on the offense and, of course, the defense. But when it comes to the offense, your guys are going to get banged up. It's just that there's no question. They're going to get banged up, hurt. We're just hoping that it's not anything serious like we always seem to face year in and year out. And I think that's what's going to be different this year is the fact that Ron Rivera has tried his best to bring in good quality depth to this offense. And I think that we're going to see this transpire into hopefully more points, but a much better, solid, consistent offense. And finally, Scott Turner. Now, you know, because of not having depth, because of not having a solid quality quarterback that you can depend on, hopefully week in and week out, Scott Turner really couldn't expand and just really open up his playbook. Now, I thought he had some very good plays that he called last year, but I dare say, I doubt that he really got deep into his playbook. And when you have a good quality quarterback, and I think we do have one in Ryan Fitzpatrick, but when you have a good quality starting quarterback who just gets it, and you got all of these wide receivers that you can choose from, and then hopefully you have a good quality running back group in the backfield and decent depth outside of Antonio Gibson, you got all these tight ends. You got John Bates, who has really looked very good in OTAs, and of course Logan Thomas, who just exploded as a tight end last year. If you're Scott Turner, you can look at this and be like, wow, suddenly I can become creative with my play calling. I can bring in different formations that we could not do last year. One example, I think, is because that we didn't have a lot of depth behind Logan Thomas, we were not able to really run a lot of tighter, maybe pro set type of formations because, well, quite frankly, we didn't have the depth and the quality at tight end. Now we have that. Just being able to have quality depth all across the board, I think that's really going to help as far as Scott Turner. It's going to help with injuries and being able to sustain a consistent offense. And it's going to have just a big positive effect on this team. So in summary, Ryan Fitzpatrick, finally quality at the quarterback position. I mean, honestly, we have not had consistency at quarterback since Kirk Cousins. I guess you could kind of say Alex Smith, but you know, with him getting hurt in 2018, he was only playing quarterback for us for about 10 games. Having Ryan Fitzpatrick, having quality depth at wide receiver, having Antonio Gibson, who could actually be much improved this year, having depth, and then being able to open up the playbook even more for Scott Turner, that is five great reasons why I think that the Washington football team's offense will be greatly improved in 2021. Hey, if you like this video, please give it a like. Leave me a comment in the comment section. Let me know what you liked about it. And give me your thoughts. What are your thoughts on the offense? Do you think it's going to be improved, or do you think we're going to see the same stuff over and over again? High hopes and just, you know, dreams shattered. Hopefully not, though. As well, if you're really enjoying this channel, please consider subscribing. And also, please visit our Patreon site. Please consider becoming a sponsor today. I appreciate our sponsor that we have right now, ATA Custom Painting. Check them out. They do great work. And with all of that said, hell to the Washington football team. Everybody have a great day.